Thank you so much, Supervisor Kennedy. I cannot stop smiling, a genuine smile, that we have reached this day and that we are standing together. I want to begin with some thank yous as well. I want to start with my city partners, my colleagues, two of whom are here today who participated actively in these very important negotiations, Council Members Jeff Harris, Eric Guetta, and Council Member Jay Schneer, who couldn't be here today. I want to thank our great city manager, Howard Chan, for his unending work on creating this collaborative relationship and agreement with the County of Sacramento, as well as Mario Lada, who helped lead the negotiations. Thank you. Our city attorney and her team, Susana Alcala. I want to thank my personal staff, Marilyn Villinga, who's worked so hard on this with me. And of course, he's standing in the back there, Judge Lloyd Connolly, who knows the county world very, very well, and the state world and the city world, and worked as a volunteer in my office for almost 12 months as all of this journey was on its way, and helped put this together. Grateful to you. I want to thank the business community. I don't know if they're here, but the Chamber of Commerce and Region Business for their work, their pressure, in ways that help bring us to this day. I want to thank Sacramento Act. It's long been calling for a city-county partnership agreement. I want to thank the providers. Aaron, you're here, and so many others who have been in this field for a long time and have waited for this moment. I want to thank our neighborhoods and our business organizations who have been demanding change. And I have not forgotten anybody, believe me, because now I want to extend my heartfelt thank you to the County of Sacramento, where we gather here today. Supervisors Kennedy and Desmond, you have done great work, and I'm grateful to both of you. Ann Edwards and Siobhan Qatari deserve a tremendous amount of credit, as Supervisor Kennedy stated, for being creative and being willing. This county council and all who participated on the county side. It is no secret that the city and county have had our challenges together over the years. The journey that has brought us here today has not been easy. So I want to state loudly and clearly the following. With this agreement, the county is stepping up big time. They are taking a step that is bold, that is far-reaching, and that provides the best chance we've had together to impact this terrible problem that dominates the agendas of every major city and county in our state. The agreement that both sides, as Supervisor Kennedy said, will approve next Tuesday is comprehensive, it is detailed, and it is groundbreaking. Supervisor Kennedy covered a significant amount of the detail, and I know some of my colleagues will fill in the gaps, but here are the highlights from my perspective in the way that I say it. The city and county and the health plans contracting with the counties, they're a key piece of this through the state, what's known as the state Cal-AIM reform, will add 50 outreach workers to aggressively intervene in the most problematic encampments in the city of Sacramento. 10 teams will be responsible for working 20 separate encampments per month in the city. That's not some little pilot. That's 20 encampments per month. Each team will have a clinically trained mental health worker funded by the counties, with the authority to diagnose people with mental health and substance abuse issues on the spot and in the encampments themselves. The teams will also include housing navigators and peer specialist, and the DCR representatives from the city of Sacramento. The size of the teams will vary with the size of and complexity of the particular encampment. For large encampments, the teams will spend whatever number of days or weeks are necessary to navigate people out into better conditions. Now, assertive outreach is a cornerstone of this agreement. Assertive community outreach, it's essential, but it is not enough. For several years, as you know, I have advocated both in Sacramento and in California for a legal right to housing, shelter, and care for people in the most desperate need. This agreement is the first of its kind, a voluntary legal agreement which requires the city and county to work together, not just one side, but both sides to work together. Maybe more importantly, it will guarantee whatever it takes for the people in desperate need. Mental health services, substance abuse services, housing services, general assistance, whatever it takes will be guaranteed to help get people off the streets. Under the agreement, the services to be offered are first voluntary, and if necessary, the county agrees to invoke Laura's Law or other legal tools to require the individual to accept the help. Under the agreement, the county is also bravely committing to adding as many of what are called full-service partnerships under Prop 63, the Mental Health Services Act, which is the highest level of service for people with the most severe needs. The city will work with the county, and the city will ultimately prioritize the sites. 20 a month once the teams are fully staffed over the next 6 months. But here's the among many important things, another important thing to say to the public. We together are not waiting. The city and county have been actually working together on a pilot basis for several months. So they are ready to go, even as we ramp up the 10 full teams. Next week, we will have two city-county teams, including a county behavioral health worker, going out to work with people in some of the encampments the city has deemed to pose the greatest and highest risk to health and safety. These include the X Street corridor and 29th and 30th Streets from E to H Streets in the central city and Hagenwood Park, Traction Avenue, and Colfax in North Sacramento. And that's the beginning. Then we will keep going together. The health and housing centered agreements, I want to make clear, do not preclude humane enforcement, because I know that's a question that's going to come up. What does that mean? Well, in these encampments on the front end, where there are people who are engaging in illegal activity, who are preying on other people by selling drugs, by engaging in assault or whatever, there's a role for law enforcement on either the city or county side, I suppose the city police function, to enforce the law. And then once this exhaustive health and human services centered approach is completed, and again, voluntary and involuntary services, after however long it takes that is aggressive but reasonable, then the city and county together will decide, okay, what happens if an encampment remains? But the goal here is to make sure that many of these encampments don't remain the way they are, because we've actually helped navigate people off the street. Two more points, and I will cede the stage here. Implementation is everything, which is why I'm so pleased that the city and county not only worked so hard to forge this agreement, but have worked just as hard to begin planning for and actually operationalizing implementation. In fact, as late as this morning, meeting to figure out what those first what those first interventions and where they will be. Because we all know that a written agreement, no matter how strong it is only as strong as the will to implement it in the right way. So we're going to continue the spirit and the work that we have done together to make sure that 20 a month, that gets you to hundreds of encampments, potentially, if we continue and as we build and as we build these teams. Last point, in conclusion, no single agreement will miraculously solve this problem, under no illusions. I've done this long enough. On the other hand, no one can make progress acting alone. And that's sort of the way that it has been. I mean, despite a lot of good efforts, that's the way it's sort of been. And it's led to frustration and frustration from the public. But as Patrick said, it is a new day. It's a new day. It's a great day. It's a historic day. Let's get started together. I'm really happy. Thank you very much, everybody. Let me now turn it over to Sacramento County Rich Desmond, who really, along with Patrick, did a great job here, representing only a tiny sliver of the city, by the way. There he was, meeting after meeting, helping do this work. Thank you.